Visit the YouTube channel and subscribe for more oncology videos. Carcinoma cervix. Then vagina is lined by squamous epithelium, which is pale pink in color. Cervical canal is lined by columnar epithelium, which is pinkish red in color. Hence, there is a squamocolumnar junction in cervix, which is well-defined landmark. This squamocolumnar junction is defined at birth. After puberty and pregnancy, lactobacilli grows as vaginal flora. Lactobacilli produces acid which lowers pH of vagina, thereby preventing ascending infection. However, this protecting mechanism is a double-edged sword. Acid bathes columnar epithelium of cervix, which is less resistant to acid than squamous epithelium. As a protective reflex, basal cells of columnar epithelium undergo a change to squamous epithelium. This process of conversion of one type of epithelium to another mature epithelium is called metaplasia. New squamous epithelium thus leads to two squamocolumnar junction, one old one and other new one. Between two lies transformation zone. In transformation zone, squamous cells are rapid dividing, immature. Transformation zone is a dynamic zone, constantly changing. This zone is site for carcinoma cervix. However, development of carcinoma also requires insult from human papilloma virus. Main presentation of carcinoma cervix is abnormal vaginal bleeding. This is most common symptom. Post-coital bleeding is usually early sign in sexually active females, and this may lead to early diagnosis. Those females who are not sexually active, especially postmenopausal females, have risk of presenting late by postmenopausal bleeding. There could be foul-smelling discharge, infection of large tumors which contains deep crevices where bacteria may lodge. When examining a suspected case of CA cervix, we look for signs of distant mets or non-regional nodes, and then we go for perspeculum inspection and pervaginal and perrectal examination. On pervaginal examination, most important things to note are size of mass, extent of involvement of cervix, perimetrial involvement, vaginal wall involvement. Perimetrial tissue is tissue present by the side of uterus and cervix. It is assessed through fornices. If there is induration felt deep to fornix, there could be perimetrial involvement. However, fornicial wall limits our palpation of high perimetrial tissue, so best method for checking perimetrial involvement is by perrectal examination. On speculum examination, CA cervix can present as exophytic growth, ulcerated, polypoidal tumor or hard or firm cervix with no visible growth. This usually happens in case where CA develops an endocervical canal, so cervix appears normal as ectocervix is unaffected. But due to invasion of stroma, there is increased firmness of cervix. In case there is visible growth, punch biopsy is done. If there is no growth but cervix is firm to hard on palpation, then endocervical curettage will diagnose. In case where cytology is suspicious, then colposcopy is done if there is no growth. If colposcopic biopsy is negative, then conization is done. In conization, a cone of cervix is removed with apex inside, thereby removing ectocervix and endocervical canal. Cervical cancer staging is done by FIGO classification. There are four stages. In stage 1, disease is confined to cervix, initially microscopic and later gross. In stage 2, disease goes out of cervix. Upper third of vagina may get involved and perimetrium can be infiltrated with encasement of ureter. In stage 3, lower one third of vagina is involved with disease and or disease extends up to pelvic wall. Stage 4, there is distant metastasis. Contrast MRI is the best modality for imaging of cancer cervix. In cancer cervix, two most important signs a clinician would want to see in imaging are parametrial invasion and lymph nodes. Patients with parametrial invasion and nodes are usually sent for definitive RT, as even after surgery these patients would require radiation. Combined surgery and radiation increases side effects and morbidity. For parametrial invasion, MRI scores above CT scan. For lymph nodes, MRI equals CT. In cases of locally advanced cases, PET CT is useful in staging. Spread of cancer cervix is through three routes: direct, hematogenous, and lymphatics. Cancer can spread deep in cervical stroma, ascend to uterine body, go sideways in perimetrium, encasing ureter and up to pelvic wall, may spread to pelvic nodes and then to paraortic nodes, or may spread via blood to distant sites. In case of microscopic disease 1A1, if fertility is desired, then conization can be done, which means removal of a cone of cervix including ectocervix and endocervix. However, if fertile preservation is not needed, like in elderly women, then extrafascial or simple hysterectomy is done. In case of small macroscopic disease 1 or 2, if fertility preservation is needed, then radical trachelectomy is done, which means removal of cervix with paracervical and perimetrial tissue with pelvic node dissection. If pregnancy is not desired, then modified radical hysterectomy is done with pelvic node dissection, called Wertheim's hysterectomy. In gross larger disease limited to cervix, 1B to 2A, radical hysterectomy with bilateral pelvic node dissection is done, called Meigs hysterectomy. Any disease with extension outside cervix like perimetrium involvement, 2B onwards, or involved nodes, then definitive radiation is given. Uterine artery is branch of internal iliac artery and it crosses ureter anteriorly to reach uterus. Uterine artery is ligated and parametrial tissue medial to it is removed. Where it is ligated is important. More laterally it is ligated, more perimetrium is removed, hence more margin. Therefore, as stage of cervical cancer increases, ligation of uterine artery is done more and more away from uterus. Extrafascial or simple hysterectomy is type 1 hysterectomy. In this, uterine artery is ligated close to uterus, hence minimal perimetrium is removed. Thus, this is done only in microscopic tumor, where large margin is not required. In type 2, modified radical hysterectomy or Wertheim's hysterectomy, uterine artery is ligated above ureter crossing and all perimetrium medial to it is removed. It is done in smaller tumor stage 1A2. In type 3, radical or Meigs hysterectomy, uterine artery is ligated at its origin and all tissue medial to it is removed. Vaginal margin of 1 to 1.5 cm is taken. Let's understand this from another view. Axial cut. Uterus is supported by uterus acral ligament posteriorly, viscouterine anteriorly, and broad ligament laterally. Type 1 hysterectomy is close to uterus with minimal removal of attachments. Type 2 hysterectomy includes partial removal of viscouterine and uterus acral and broad ligament medial to ureter. Type 3 hysterectomy includes removal of viscouterine, major part of uterus acral and broad ligament medial to internal iliac. After surgery, if there is positive margin, positive nodes or positive perimetrium, then there is high chances of microscopic residual disease. Therefore, adjuvant radiation is done to kill those remnant cancer cells. If all above are negative but disease is high risk for microscopic dissemination, then again adjuvant radiation is given. GOG score is one such score which is used to classify tumor as high risk. Three factors: lymphovascular invasion, tumor size, and depth of stromal invasion is checked in tumor specimen. Relative risk is calculated as per their values using standard charts. All three relative risks are multiplied to generate GOG score. Usually score more than 120 are considered high risk and receive adjuvant radiation. Overall lymph node involvement is the worst prognostic factor. What to do? Simple hysterectomy is done for some benign reason like fibroid and cancer cervix comes incidentally in biopsy. In these cases, first blocks and slides are received from pathologist and reviewed again to confirm malignancy. Then imaging is done, either CT scan or one may go for PET imaging. In case there is no mets, then staging is checked. If there is any indication of adjuvant radiation, then surgery is not done and patient is sent for radiation. If bulky nodes are present, then they are removed before sending the patient for radiation. If no indication of radiation is present, then radical parametrectomy with pelvic node dissection is done.